Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with a new art journal layout. Today I'm going to use this elephant set by Stampendous. Now this comes with this foam stamp that you can stamp either way. The one side of the elephant is solid and the other one gives you a great design. And also there is a rubber stamp that matches perfectly the solid side. The kit also comes with a stencil. I'm going to catch the light for you so you can see the beautiful design. Also today I will be working on my bigger art journal. This is by Dilusions, the bigger size, just because the elephant is too big to use on my smaller Dilusions that I usually work with. So you can see the difference here. To start with, I am going to apply some acrylic paint, and today I am using my Dilusions paints. I'm applying everything with my baby wipe, and as I am using the colors, you can see which colors I am using on the screen. I am using two different baby wipes for each color, but I am using both of them to blend everything on my page. I haven't prepared my pages with gesso, so I'm working directly on the paper. And also what I love about Dilusions is that they have beautiful bright colors. They are really easy to blend and to apply. And just to deepen a little bit my background, I decided to bring in a third color, which again I am applying with my baby wipe. Now these Dilusions paints really dry super fast on your page, so you have to move quite quickly if you want to blend them nicely, but at the same time using a baby wipe which is already wet is a great idea because it extends the time that the paint dries and makes your job a little bit more easy. Now, since I was a little girl, when everyone asked me what my favorite animal was, I used to say always elephant. So when I saw the set, I just had to use it on one of my art journal layouts. So now I am using the stencil. Again, I am applying the same colors of that I have used for my background. And I am applying it by using my blending tool, the round blending tool by Tim Holtz. Using the colors that I have used on the background over the stencil, is a great tip to keep your background quite subtle. So I am going to keep it as it is. I'm happy with how my background looks and I am going to work with my elephant. When you are working with foam stamps, it's always nice if you spray a little bit of water before you start applying your acrylic paints. So you can see now I have sprayed just a little bit. Hope you can see how wet it is. And this is going to help the paint stay only at the surface, and also it's going to make your life easier when you try to clean the stamp. I am applying again Dilusions paints, and I'm going to mix up two different colors on my elephant. I find it easy to apply the paint with a foam brush, and you can see that with the same foam brush I am going to mix up my colors directly on my foam stamp. Now if you don't want to contaminate your colors, stay away from this technique. You can always use two different brushes to apply it. Of course you can use the foam stamp and stamp directly on your project, but you know how I love paper piecing, so I just had to try it on a different piece of paper first, and you will see that I am going to get a great impression. And I really have so many ideas of using this elephant set that I probably use it again and again on my projects. So you see the impression here, I really love it. And since I have all that paint, I am going to try and see if I can do second generation stamping. And you can see I really get a beautiful texture out of that. And I am also going to spritz a little bit of water and see if I can get a third impression. And these second and third generation stampings give you beautiful texture, perfect for art journal backgrounds. So now I am going to wipe it off with my baby wipe. I went to the sink to wash it. It was super easy to remove, and you can see it's totally clean, just like new. So now I am going to use the rubber stamp, and I am going to stamp directly on top of my elephant by using my black archival ink. This stamp is going to give a great texture on my elephant, and it's not a big deal if you don't stamp directly on top of it. We just need the texture for now. You see that I don't pay any attention on the fabric at the top of the elephant, since I am going to stamp it again and paper piece it later on. So for now I am going to use my scissors and cut out my cute little elephant. And for the fabric of that the elephant is wearing, I am going to use my turquoise and color just a scrap piece of paper. And then I am going to use my black archival ink and stamp again this part of the elephant on this piece of paper. Now, instead of placing the elephant on top of the paper, I am doing it the other way around so I can get a better impression. Now I can heat set it with my heat gun just a little bit, make sure that the archival ink is dry, and then I am going to use my scissors to cut it out. So although this is pretty much the same color as the elephant, you will see that when I place it on top, it's going to stand out. Now I am using again another piece of scrap paper, and I am going to blend in those two colors. These are the same colors that I have used for my elephant again. And I am going to blend them with my baby wipes. And to add a little bit of texture, I am using this stamp set, which is again by Stampendous. It has great textures for your original projects, for your backgrounds. And I am going to use this stamp that looks like a lace. And instead of using any type of ink pad, I am going to use the same paints on my stamp, so that again I get a nice subtle result. And I am planning to cut out an umbrella out of this pattern paper that I am creating at the moment. So I am going to use my pencil and draw a curve at the top and then follow the line to cut my umbrella. Now I am going to use the bottom of that stamp impression as the bottom of my umbrella, but as I cut it out, I decided that it was too big for my elephant. So I went ahead and cut it out even more. Actually, I am following the lines of the stamp that gives me a nice curve down there. So now I have a nice umbrella for my elephant. And now it's time to stick everything directly on top of my art journal. To do so, I am using a gel medium. This is matte gel medium. I'm going to stick my elephant about in the middle of my page. And I know it looks like it's flying up there, but you will see that I am going to place him on top of a string as if he is balancing there. So I am trying to decide where my umbrella is going to go. And once I'm happy with the placement, I'm going to commit and stick it down with my gel medium. I'm also covering everything, all my elements, with my gel medium, and this is going to give me the ability to use my big brush markers to do the shading later on. So I'm going to stick the fabric on top. And you can see that although it's the same color, just because it's not blended in, it stands out against the background of the elephant. So now I'm using my big brush markers for my favorite technique, and I'm going to add shadows all over the umbrella and the elephant. And as I'm doing that, just to let you know that you can find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. The shading made the elephant and the umbrella look more dimensional, and now I am going to draw the handle of my umbrella as if the elephant is holding it. To do so, I used my thin black marker, and I am also going to use this marker to go all around the elephant, and this is going to help the elephant pop even more against the background. I am not going for the perfect lines, I'm just going a little bit sketchy here, and I'm also going to do the same thing around the umbrella. And you will see that after doodling all around the umbrella, I made the lines to the center of the umbrella just to make it look more realistic, and I'm also going to use my big brass markers there to do the shadows. Another one of my go-to techniques is using my white gel pen and adding details on my elements. So I am going to do some white doodling now on the different parts of the elephant as well as on the umbrella. And I find that just a little bit of highlighting here and there with the white gel pen really helps all the elements pop even more against the background. And I love the look. And since I was using my white gel pen, I decided to do some details on the umbrella. So I am drawing those teardrops just underneath to embellish my umbrella even more. Now I had this idea to put this elephant on a string, balancing, holding his umbrella. So instead of drawing the string, I am going to actually use a piece of white string. I have placed where I want the string to go, and now I am going to stick everything down by using my gel medium. You can use any type of glue for that, but just because my matte gel medium dries totally transparent without leaving any gloss, and you won't be able to tell where the glue was, I always prefer gluing things on my page with that. And since my white thread is going all the way from one page to the other and over the fold, I decided to cut it out at the fold. You don't really see where the cut is, but at the same time it's going to help my book to open and close easier. So once everything was glued down, I used my scissors to cut out the excess thread. And now it's time to work on my quote. For my quote, I am going with those chipboard letters, and these have been on my stash for many, many years. Actually, I think those are the same chipboard letters that I have used on my cup art journal layout for writing down the word cup. So anyway, I am just coloring them black, and to do so I used my black marker. I could have used my acrylic paints also, and I am going to place them around the thread. I'm not going to place them straight, I am going to make them follow the line. So once I am happy with the placement, I am going to use my glue and stick them down, just to make sure that these are nicely stuck down. Instead of using my gel medium, I decided to go with my tacky glue. I'm going to use my white gel pen to add some highlighting on the letters, just like I always do on the big bold letters. I think that it helps them stand out even more. To stamp my quote, I am going to use this clear stamp set, and this is by KaiserCraft, and I am going to use my black archival ink. When I am stamping on an art journal, I always like to stamp two or three letters at a time and not the whole word. Just because I am working on a bulky surface, I won't get a good impression if I do otherwise. So now my layout is pretty much finished. I am going to do the finishing touches now. So again, I am using my white gel pen, adding all the highlighting on the letters, just like I did with a big balance word. I am also going to stick one tiny black enamel dot as the eye for my elephant. And I'm really happy with the outcome. And also I found in my stash those white teardrops. These are enamel dots actually, which I am going to stick underneath the umbrella in just to give it a little bit of dimension there. And that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of today's project. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more art journal layouts that I shared a while back. Thank you all for watching!